Given this charge configuration, find the E field at point P. We're going to need to use the principle of superposition to solve this problem because we have the E field due to three different charges. So we find the E field due to each respective charge and then add them up vectorially. Okay, so let's go ahead and sketch the E fields first. First, let's notice that the E field due to this guy is, because it's a positive charge, it's emanating this way. And so it's collinear in this direction, like this. The E field due to this guy is collinear and emanating this way. So because this distance is the same as this distance, these guys are going to cancel. And you'll see that show up frequently. You need to, you know, stay aware on your exam or on your homework of when you can use symmetry to just cancel components like that. So the E field is just going to be due to this positive charge right here. So we can just sketch it like that. And so the E field is going to be like that. And the E field is a vector, so we have to represent it in unit vector notation. Here we go. The magnitude of the E field is given by K times the charge that's causing the E field divided by R squared. So this is 8.99 times 10 to the 9 times Q causing, 4 times 10 to the minus 7 times 10 to the minus 7, and then divided by R squared. But R is going to be the distance from the charge to the point of consideration, which is right here. So we need this distance here. Notice that if this is A and this is A, then that means that this big distance is A square root 2. Use the Pythagorean theorem to find this big distance. And then this is the midpoint of this line. And so this distance here is going to be A square root 2 over 2. And this distance is going to be A square root 2 over 2. If this is A square root 2 over 2, that means that this is going to be a square root 2 over 2, because notice, this is a and this is a, so that means this is 45 degrees. This is 45 degrees, and then look, this angle is 90 degrees because you have 90 and 90. You know, the sum of these two angles has to be 180 degrees. So if this is 90 and this is 45, that means this is 45 degrees right here also. So if this distance is a square root 2 over 2, that means this distance is a square root 2 over 2. And if you calculate that, you will get plugging in 0.1 meters, because 10 centimeters is equal to 0.1 meters. You'll get 0.0707 meters. Okay? So we put that here. 0.0707, and then square that quantity. Keep your equal signs on top of one another as you move down the derivation. And you will find that this number is 7.2 times 10 to the fifth. 7.2 times 10 to the fifth newtons per coulomb. Okay? And it looks like that is not quite on top. And it's useful, I'm telling you, you do this. You keep it neat here, you keep it neat here. And the solutions will present themselves more readily. Like this. Okay, but that's just the magnitude of the E field. We need to sketch it, we need to write it down in unit vector notation. Notice, if we take a look at this vector here, this angle is 45 degrees right here, which means that this angle right here is 45 degrees. Because look, this line and this line are parallel with one another, and so this angle is equal to this angle. So we can say the E field is a vector is equal to this number times the cosine of 45 degrees x hat plus this number times the sine of 45 degrees y hat to get the components. So this is 7.2 times 10 to the fifth times the cosine of 45 degrees x hat plus 7.2 times 10 to the fifth times the sine of 45 degrees y hat. And then that's equal to, the units of that are newtons per coulomb. And if we simplify that, we will obtain multiplying 7.2 times 10 to the fifth times the cosine of 45 times cosine of 45. And the cosine of 45 is equal to the sine of 45, which is the square root of 2 over 2, right? And so that number comes out to be 508,551 newtons per coulomb. I'm going to write that, I'm going to put that in scientific notation. Normal, switch normal to scientific. 5.1 times 10 to the fifth. So this is 5.1 times 10 to the fifth x hat plus 5.1 times 10 to the fifth y hat newtons per coulomb. And that's it. Okay, try it out. Shows up. See you next time.